The Spokane mother of three alleged child molestation victims has a warning for parents. Well, that woman was in court today when the man accused of molesting her daughters pleaded not guilty. KXOY4's Jeff Humphrey has our exclusive story and this mother's advice for all parents. Jeff?
Nadine, I am really afraid that this lady partially blames herself for what happened to her daughters, not because she knew about the alleged abuse. She really didn't, but I think she would tell you that she did not have enough of those good touch, bad touch talks with her daughters. It's a very important conversation that a lot of parents are still missing.
Charles Fletcher is suspected of molesting three girls as they each matured enough to be sexually attractive to him. In the spring of 2012, when Fletcher learned Spokane police were closing in, Fletcher left the country.
We were in the process of finishing the investigation when Mr. Fletcher left the country and went to the Republic of Georgia.
But late last month, an FBI agent and a Spokane police officer flew to the Georgian Republic and finally took Fletcher into custody.
I need you to enter a plea of guilty. You're not guilty to those five counts. How do you plead, sir?
Not guilty.
Today, Fletcher was in Spokane Superior Court, and one of his alleged victims and her mom were there waiting for him. This mother says we all need to do a better job warning our kids about their right to go unmolested.
As soon as a child's old enough to understand, explain what bad touch is. Explain that, you know, the parts of the body covered by underwear, that's a very personal space. And to encourage their children to come forward if anything inappropriate happens.
She likens Fletcher's actions to a disease like polio. Kids need to be exposed to some of the dirtier things about our world so they can better protect themselves from it.
I think if parents don't talk about it with their children and don't explain to them what bad touch is, the same thing can happen to them. They're not inoculated with the truth. They're not inoculated with the reality.
And so this mother is now helping her daughters any way she can. She wishes those teens had known that their claims about abuse would have been taken seriously if they had only spoken up about what was happening to them.
That breaks the cycle. And that's what I want to see with all my heart, is that cycle be broken.
And so, Nadine, this mom thinks if you care enough about your kids to tell them to not play with matches or don't play in the street, then you also need to tell them there are people out there who would like to sexually abuse them. And that's because of these alarming statistics, Nadine. One out of every three girls and one out of every six boys will be sexually abused by the time they turn 18.
Wow, those are really high numbers. Thanks a lot, Jeff. Hey, by the way, more often than not, children sexually abused by people they know and trust. That's the case.
Well, your mama was right when she told you not to talk to strangers, and we do have every once in a while attempted lurings here in Spokane, but in 93% of the time, the victims already knew the people who sexually assaulted them, and 34% of the time, they were living underneath the same roof.
Wow. All right. Thanks a lot, Jeff.